Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We're doing chapter 111, Surah Al-Masad, the poem fiber. Look at verse number 1. We've got tabbat, root letters tabbah, which means to perish or be destroyed. It is in the fi'l madi form, which is your past tense verb. The fa'il or doer is yada, which is in marfu, and it is also feminine, which is a requirement of the ta prefix at the end of tabbat. Yada means two hands. It's a dual body part, which is often feminine. Abi means father, and it is a mudaf in ilay, relating back to yada, which is the mudaf. The nun of yadani has dropped away because it is mudaf. And the hidden al, or definiteness, is also associated with it. Then we look at lahab. This means flame or blaze. It is the mudaf and ilay, relating back to abi, which is mudaf, and also has the hidden al, or definiteness, associated with it. Then we've got wa, which is a waw atifa, or conjunction, which means and. Tabba, which means to perish or be destroyed. It is in the fi'l madi form, which is your past tense verb. The fa'il or doer is the huwa or he inside the verb. Looking at meaning now, we've got the hands of the father of flame perished, and he perished or it perished. Of course, Abi Lahab, father of flame, according to tafsir, is actually an actual person who lived in that time. Looking at verse number 2, we've got ma, which is your harf nafi, or negative particle. And we've got aghna, root letters ghaniya, which means to be free from want, self-sufficient, or rich. It is form 4. It is a fi'l madin, or past tense verb. Then we've got anhu, which is a standard jar wa majrur concept. And an just generally means about, and hu means him. Then we've got maluhu. Now the malu is your fa'il, which relates back to aghna, and it is always in marfu. Then the hu, which is a damir attached to the noun, is your mudaf nilay, making malu your mudaf. Wama, the wa, is your waw atifa, or conjunction, which means and. Ma is your ma mawsul, which means what or which. Kasaba, root letters kasaba, which means to earn or to gain. It is a fi'l madin, which is a past tense verb, and the fa'il or doer is the hidden huwa or he inside the verb. If you look at meaning, we can say the fa'il first. His wealth will not avail him, and what he gained. Looking at verse number 3, we've got sayasla. Sa is your harfu istiqbal, or your prefix future particle, which means soon. Yasla, root letters salaya, which means to burn. It is in the fi'l mudari form, which is your present future form. The fa'il or doer is huwa, or the hidden he inside the verb. Naron means fire, and it is the maf'ulun bihi, or the done upon, relating back to the verb, and this is always in mansub. Data means consisting of, and it is the sifa or descriptive word relating back to naron. Lahab means blazing flame, and it is the mudaf nilay relating back to data, which would be your mudaf. What is your waw atifa or conjunction? And it means and. Imra'atu is your mubtada or subject. This was in marfu. Who is your mudaf ilay? Relating back to imra'atu, which is your mudaf. And this is the of concept. Hammalata means to be the carrier. And it indicates a condition. And this is what we mean by hal. It indicates the condition of relating back to imra'atu, which is wife. Then we've got al-hatab, which means firewood. This is the mudaf ilayh relating back to hammalata. So this is once again the of concept between those two. Looking at the entire line, we've got soon he will burn in a fire consisting of blazing flames, and his wife will be the carrier of the firewood. Looking at verse number 5, we've got fi jidiha. Fi jidi, simply your jar wa majrur concept. Fi means in, jid means neck. The ha is a damir attached to jid, and it is your mudaf ilay, which is your of concept, and the ha means her. Habalun means rope, and it is your khabar or your news in this sentence. Mim masad, min and masad, this is your jar and your majrur concept. Min means from, masad means palm fiber. Looking at the entire verse, we've got in her neck, or the neck of her, is a rope from palm fiber.